Warm welcome to this third conference on implementation of NPS in the central government and central government institution. As you are aware, this NPS was started from 1st January 2004 for the new recruits to central government other than the armed forces. Subsequently, it was opened to the state government employees and to the private sector also, including the unorganized sector. Now today, we have all the central ministries, most of the central autonomous institutions, all state governments except West Bengal and Tripura, only for the state employees. West Bengal and Tripura have not yet implemented for the state employees. It has been implemented for the all India services. And Tamil Nadu has moved from the defined benefit pension, old pension, to contributory pension, but they are managing the funds on their own. The money doesn't come to our system. Like of the total subscriber base of 1 crore 12 lakh, that includes only the NPS, not the other pension. Now we have another 7-8 lakh in other pension. So the central government employees and CAPS account for 18.96 lakh, say 19 lakh. That is about 17% of the subscriber base. And of the total pension AUM, the corpus of 2 crore 15 lakh, the central government and central autonomous institution account for 81,000 crore. That is about 38% of the AUM. We have over 4,608 pay and accounts offices which are uploading the subscriber file and remitting through their banks the NPS contribution to the trust, NPS trust, that is the Axis Bank in the account of the NPS trust, and about 19,000 DDOs, you know, who prepare the bills. Our returns in the CG scheme, central government scheme, have been over 10% since inception. Like this is compound average growth rate. You know, the idea of having these conferences with our stakeholders periodically, and like the PAOs, the DDOs, they are an important element of the NPS stakeholders. The idea is to impress upon them the basic change in the philosophy of a contributory pension scheme as against a defined benefit, unfunded, pay as you go pension. The old pension scheme, there was no contribution by the subscriber. In the new pension scheme, there is contribution by the subscriber and an equal contribution by the employer, that is by the government, which comes upfront. And then for management of these funds, like that responsibility is trusted to us. Now it becomes absolutely necessary that people who are to be covered under NPS are registered under NPS immediately on their joining. Their subscriber contribution files are prepared in time and their NPS contribution is remitted to the trustee bank on the day of payment of their salaries. If the last working day of the month happens to be the payday for salary, it should be uploaded on the same day. To this effect, there are detailed guidelines issued by the Department of Expenditure. It was done way back in 2009. And it has mentioned that like the salary bill or the NPS bill should reach to the pain accounts office by 20th of the month. The SCF should be uploaded on the CRA NPS scan by 25th of the month, and the NPS contribution should be remitted to the trustee bank on the day of the service. Now why so? Because once the money comes through the system, then it gets invested in financial securities by the pension fund. If it is not in the system, there cannot be any investment. If there is no investment, there cannot be any return. Now it is possible that two persons joining on the same day, one in very efficient office where all these dates or timelines are, you know, followed very rigorously, and the other one in an office which is not so efficient, they will have different pension corpus, even though their career progression, career development might have been the same. Like both joined at the same labor, same salary, they had the same promotional avenues, they are retiring at the same level of salary, same scale of pay, but the pension could be quite different. Because the money has not come in time, it is not invested, so that fellow, I mean, whose office was not efficient enough to remit the money in time, would not be having enough pension corpus. And then that gentleman would have a genuine cause for grievance. He may also go to a court of law also. For, in order to ensure that there is proper monitoring by the offices, there was a circular issued by, again, Department of Expenditure in July 2011, which clearly said that there should be a committee comprising of the financial advisors of the ministries, joint secretary, administration, principal controller of accounts or CCA, controller as the case may be. And what they should look into, registration of the subscriber, that is timely registration of the subscribers, regular upload of SCFs, remittance of the NPS contribution to the trustee bank, reconciliation of the unreconciled balances. Like, you know, in the initial stages, we got the money without complete details about the subscriber. The money is in the system, but we do not know which subscriber it pertains to. There have been constant dialogue between the trustee bank, CRA, with many pay accounts offices, but there is some amount still left unreconciled. That needs to, you know, people, some of the people might be reaching their superannuation, they would require their money to be paid back, but unless it is reconciled, it cannot be paid back. And then, you know, prompt action on grievances and their resolution. And this committee was to meet quarterly and submit its report to Secretary Expenditure. We do not know whether this committee is actually meeting or not. My request to all the officers here is that please meet your FAs, meet your Joint Secretary, Administration, and have these committees activated. I mentioned there are many non-individual retirement account plans, like we do not have complete details about the people. There are many accounts which have been opened, but there is no credit in the plan since the opening of the account. It is possible that some of the people have joined. No, they join, they open the pension account and then they left the service or they got transferred to some other service, some other department. But that intimation needs to be given to CRA. Then there are plans without nominations. It is absolutely necessary that every plan has complete details including the nomination, because in the event of that subscriber, you know, having some mishap, at least the proceeds can be paid to the nominee if we have the record. Otherwise, the system is one has to have that legal year which is appointed through a court, succession certificate, or, you know, there are a lot of requirements, documentary requirements, which takes a lot of time. Then there are PAOs registered in the system, and we monitor how many PAOs registered in the system are actually uploading the subscriber contribution file. We have done this study for the last 1 year month-wise, and it is observed that about 85 to 86% of the PAOs are only uploading the SCFs. There are many PAOs who are not uploading the SCFs also. So I do not know as to why they got registered if there are no subscribers under them. And if there are subscribers, why they are not uploading the SCS? There are pending grievances. Like, you know, people might have given some request to their PEOs for certain changes, but they have not yet been attended. Of the 900 grievances, about 400 are still pending for over 1 year. We share these lists with all the PEOs and DDOs. And the PEOs and DDOs can also log in on the system on their own also. They can see all their underlying subscriber, their details, whose contribution has been uploaded, whose has not been done, grievance attended, not attended, who is superannuating when, whether his request has been attended to or not. There are 330 active cases, like people who have superannuated, which are 330 active cases pending for more than 18-36 months. Another 200 are pending for over 36 months. That means over 3 years. Now see, the fellow who has retired about 3 years back, he has submitted the paper, but the DDO or PEO have not yet submitted these things to our NPS, NSDL, the Central Record Keeping Agency. As a result, his pension proceeds cannot be passed on to him and given to the NPS service provider for periodic pension. Now what happens is, if the money is in our system, it has to be liquidated, the securities have to be incashed, and then you get the proceeds. Now if 3 years back, the market was not good, the market was fairly good, now it has come down. So it impacts his proceeds. Who will be responsible for that? It can happen either way. So, you know, he will have a genuine grievance against the officers. Non-initiation of withdrawal request even after superannuation. Like, there are 1957 requests, like people have retired, of which 983 are pending for more than 12 months. People have superannuated, but their request have not yet been processed by the system. Now these have financial implication for the subscriber. These have financial implication for the office, because the PFRDA Act has very onerous responsibility on us. Like, we have to ensure that the system is run very efficiently and effectively. And there are quantity penalties, there are fines also. At some point of time, we ourselves will be accountable. What did we do? So, you know, we will be asked to take some action. If we do that, normally what it would be, there will be compensation to the employee whose pension has been compromised, and there could be some fine on the office also. Now the moment there is a fine on the office, where from to pay? Why the, like, you know, government have made the pension contribution periodically while releasing the pay. Why was it not uploaded? So there could be question, there could be administrative action against the errant PAO or DDOs. So please, you know, I'm just trying to make you aware about the consequences. There will be time at which we have to take all these actions. And it affects the trust and confidence in the system. It speaks poorly about our functioning. In the sense that if, you know, government had launched this NPS, and if people do not have faith, trust in the system, there will be hue and cry. Now it is information age. People have access to the senior most person in the government. So there could be problem. So my request to all of you would be, please pay little more attention to your duties so that we do not face the consequences which are possible under the Act. So with these words, I thank you once again for coming here, and please, you know, there are detailed presentations during the course of the day. We will revisit some of these issues in detail. So thank you very much.